different tournaments, you know, different tournaments all around the area. There's, you know, several going around by a couple around the Bay Area. Yeah, just the, what a lovely play at. You know, last week, what, we're in, no, 2 weeks ago, week and a half ago? We were in San Diego.
Yeah, that's what I saw. That's crazy.
Basically the last stop in the public system.
Right.
Yeah. be at a charter school. And I'm like, oh, that sounds cool. And next thing I know, my a day before school opens up for students, every introduction, I'm like, I gave them a little, we have charter schools. And then I guess my director heard me talk. He's like,
a new rheumatologist, a new
see if you can, you know, keep it alive.
Right. It's definitely different than Florida. I mean,
to Florida, you went over there to fix it. I'd say a rudderless ship, right?
Yep. Yep. And then they ended up. And I just didn't do my homework enough on the organization. And it was a horrible organization.
Oh.
And so they were doing bad things. They ended up selling.
Call Megan. Come on, Shane.
Oh, there we go. There we go. Oh, unlucky spin.
Yeah, that was unlucky. So they were skimping, like they were having their ear not sitting with patients who didn't even admit it.
Just to get to little.
Yeah. And I caught on to some of that, and I had some words with the CFO, and I'm like, I kept calling and looking for the CEO, and I'm like, are you hearing this? My surgeons were complaining that the OR lights were bad. Like they're like, I can't see very well in the OR. I'm like, did you talk to the director of the OR? Yeah. She said we can't really buy anything until capital equipment, blah blah blah. All the time. So
wait, hold on.
Right.
Yeah, that.
Right.
The blood's going this way, so that's gotta be an A.
So I go to the CEO and I'm like, what's going on? I'm like, tell me what's happening. He's like, well, we said blah, so we'll put it for same capital blah. I'm like, alright, so I got my surgeons to be like, are you guys good? Can you guys manage this for a couple months? Yeah, we'll be alright. Okay.
Yeah, then twice.
So, a couple months goes by. I'm sitting in the exec meeting and going through the capital blah. There's no OR lights.
Yeah.
I said, Tim, where's the OR light? He's like, before he could speak, he's like starting to speak. And then the CFO jumps in and he goes, what's the return on investment on OR lights?
Holy shit.
I said, well, maybe the fact that we're not going to kill somebody? I don't know. He's like, this is CFO looks me dead in the eyes and says, that's why we pay malpractice insurance.
Oh.
I said, are you flipping kidding me? I was like, I hope one day I don't have to, you know, come to you and give you a check for your mother, aunt, uncle, daughter, wife, whoever it is that died on the operating table because the surgeon couldn't see, and say, well, at least we paid our malpractice insurance, here's your check. I walked out of the boardroom.
That's
and
some tough.
And I didn't go back.
That's some tough stuff to hear that.
Yeah, so I was like, that's how I ended up back in New York. It's like,
wow.
I just go north.
I miss the snow anyways.
Oh, really? Well, I couldn't handle the heat anyways.
The humidity?
Dude, I step outside and like just start sweating. But people are always like, well, in New York, you know, like, we get 100 inches of snow every year. And they're like, we can't go outside 3 months of the year. I'm like, you can't go outside 3 months of the year in Florida either. Like, my kids would sit there and like, I want to go outside. Like, little kids out in the window, I want to go outside. I'm like, dude, you're going to get heat stroke. You can't go outside. The pool in the backyard was 90 degrees.
You had to wait till like,
you know,
midnight,
I mean? Like,
1 o'clock just came.
Instead of a heater, I needed something to cool the water.
A friend of mine lives in Palm Springs.
Yeah.
She says that you just walk out of the backyard, you walk through the pool, it's not even refreshing, you get out, you don't even bother drying yourself off,
yeah.
And you go back in the house.
Yeah.
And it's a bath.
It is. And the humidity is worse. The humidity is strong, right? You just can't get rid of it. And then, you know, they were still little at the time, right? So they wanted to play on the playground. The slide was like blistering.
Melting.
Hot. So it's like, we stayed inside the whole time. The beach, the water is literally 85 degrees.
French when you're in a grocery line.
There you go, trilingual, man. Trilingual.
There's nobody speaking Spanish.
Did your
Spanish skills come in handy there?
No.
It's perfect for Brian.
Huh?
Perfect for Brian.
Perfect for Brian.
No need
it's
for
horrible.
Spanish. I've seen it play on TV, and I'm like, it looks cool.
Oh, those two girls
are
totally
bummed.
Yeah, they had a little help. I should say a big help.
Trend here now. they were gold plated Legos.
I was just thinking that they'll be kind of exploratory. We bought them some gifts, like some things. And, but I put them in the trunk. And I had the trunk open and Phil had his bag and he's like, I'm like, no, put it in the bag. Put it in the trunk. And he's like, no, I just put it, I said, put it in the trunk. He said, there's nothing in it. So we did, sure.
No, you got to get him some, just some reason to make him think that.
Oh.
Suspect that there's something in there.
He learned a lesson.
Aww. Is that a tough lesson to learn, though?
Yeah, well, at least there was nothing. I mean, other than headache.
Just to experience that,
yeah,
though.
It's just